City. You're going to work 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. standing on your mats, your feet fall off, and you aren't able to stand up. But 5 weeks from now, pretty ladies are going to be the best damn show this town's ever seen. And you're on your way to glory, and $32 a week. Anybody who doesn't think he can take it, is going to quit right now. Buddy, good thing a half hour to get measured for wigs and costumes, and let's get to work.
Miss Penny Sawyer, 125 Elm Street, Allentown, PA. You go to your fitting. I'll see what she gets.
Okay.
Julian, that was a great speech, and you won't regret a word of it. Pretty Lady's the best show we've ever written.
And now with the greatest director on Broadway.
I'm a soft soap, or I need this show as much as you do.
Wall Street touch you too.
You know the old saying, there's a horse's ass for every light on Broadway. I've given all I had to that glittering gulch out there, and it's been a hell of a ride. Okay, so the press got me down to the count, but I'm still Julian Marsh, damn it. Pretty Lady's gonna put me back on top. Now let's talk about the cast.
Best in town.
Brock, I'm worried about. Her last hit was 10 years ago.
We have to use her, Julian. She's got Abner Dillon in her back pocket.
Yeah, you know Dillon's key card. They just need to put up to a whole 100,000 of Jesus' car.
But she can't dance.
Put a lot of girls around her. Let her wave her arms a lot. The public will never know the difference.
I don't know, Lanky.
Easy, Marsh. Here she is. Dorothy, allow me to introduce.
No, don't say a word. I want to get his myself. Mr. Marsh, ever since I was a tiny little girl and saw my first Julian Marsh show, I dreamed of the day when I might work with the King of Broadway. Alas, that day has come, and I am filled with pride, joy, and humility. Your Majesty, a humble subject salutes you.
Thanks, Miss Brock. You may rise. Now, before we go any further, I'd like to try you out on one of the numbers.
Oh, no, Mr. Marsh, you don't have to try out. She's already got her contract.
Mr. Dillon, what would I do without you? By the way, there were a few items you forgot to mention, so I wrote to you. Limousine, redecorated dressing room, private maid. No problem about the salary, I just added another zero.
Oh, see you, Dillon.
Of course, if there are any objections, I won't insist. We'll just peddle our kitty cars, and you go to peddle your fish.
You're not hearing me, Miss Brock. I'd like to try you on one of the songs to see if you can handle the role.
If you're asking me to audition, Mr. Marsh, I'm afraid the answer is no.
Oh, wait, no, Dorothy, it's not an audition, Dorothy. See, Julia just wants to find out if it's in the right key.
Try that new one we sent over to you yesterday, Dorothy. You are going to love it. Now, first I see you in this low down dive.
Here am I,
I got you. Look behind you.
Do you take me in your arms and let me cling to you? Let me linger long. Let me cry. Let me bring the spring up to you.
course, that works best if Ford just watch.
Hey, kid, I've been looking for you. How about having lunch?
Sorry, just come see Mrs. Jones, the girl. Would you like to join us?
No, thanks. I'm looking for a mouthful, not an earful. Don't feel bad. I'll let you have a rain check.
What makes tanners such clothes?
I mean, that tight underwear they wear.
No, that's what makes them tanners. Come along, girl. I'm going to take you to that lovely place with the windows.
The after room?
The automat. Right, the gypsy tea kettle. But you've got to dance your way over. I don't want to waste any time.
Oh, but I don't know your steps.
Well, if you think you can do it, I'll show you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Street. Now, you kids get back in there. Well, this is great. Just great.
Is something wrong, boss?
A shy one girl. That's what's wrong.
Boss, you told me to pick 2 dozen.
Plus one for good measure.
I didn't really say
that. I always pick one for good. I need any excuses. Just get me another girl.
Well, maybe I could have one here first thing in the morning.
Oh, that's just ducky. I can hardly wait. And I'm supposed to set the boardwalk number this afternoon.
Yeah.
You know, I've got a good mind to just walk up to the first girl I see on the street. I mean, just take the first dame who happens to pass by and say, you.
Who, me?
Yeah, you. You that?
That I could never.
Are you okay, Jim?
Oh, she's amazing!
Thank God!
I'm pretty small. She didn't eat any lunch.
All right, Billy, Matt, put her in Doc's dressing room. The rest of you, this is a star rehearsal, Andy.
Yeah.
Come on, let's get up that last section before the film.
All right, Oscar, hit my stick to the front of the table.
Are you going to get back out there before the war starts yelling for you?
Oh, it's not too tough. I'll be back as soon as I get a break. And the name is on. Billy Mullen.
Are you all right?
Great.
Good guess.
But I guess I'm okay now.
Bad guess. Now, you let me be the doctor for a while. You need some rest.
Rehearsal
isn't over. Oh, yes, it is, young lady. For you, anyway. Now, as your doctor, my first prescription is for you to sit on that chair.
I'm being
watchful. And as your doctor, my second prescription is for you to get these plates up.
And I'll bet I know what you're saying. But it's quite obvious you didn't expect me. Doctor.
Darn, she faces it. They brought her in here because she came too.
Since when has my dressing room been an emergency ward for any wet-footed Kareem and Fred's little fainting act? Now get her out of here before I prescribe a little medication. She won't like some art.
Please,
you shut up. And if my prescription upsets you, Doctor, you can just get out with her.
What the hell is going on here? I'm trying to conduct a rehearsal on that stage. Who are you?
My name's Pat Nettie. I was against Miss Brox.
Well, be it. Miss Brock's official gentleman's friend happens to be in the house, and I don't want him to get any funny ideas.
Dorothy!
It's Abner. Oh, Pat, quit behind the shed.
There we are. Come right in, Mr. Dillon. Come right in. We were just having a little script conference. Hello, Sugar Plum. I just brought these phones he's heard.
Thank you.
Oh, I wasn't interrupting anything. No, no, not at all. Just winding up. By the way, this is one of our dancers, Peggy Sawyer, and her boyfriend, Pat Stenning.
Say,
Mr. Dillon, do you realize that it's your fault that this conference is breaking up? Oh, why, yes. Dorothy just said she didn't want to discuss the script any further because she wanted to be alone with you.
Do you mean that, Dorothy?
Well, of course I mean it. What girl wouldn't want to be alone with you? Just look at yourself.
Your presence in this dressing room has caused a great deal of unnecessary turmoil, and I suggest such visits do not occur again. Mr. Dang, this kid's a pretty good hooker, and I don't want to lose her over the price of a bowl of chili. Take her out and get her something to eat. Thank you, Nick. Pleasure doing business with you. And that, I come back.
is making my entrance 10 seconds before the blackout.
Are you suggesting I bring you on after the blackout?
I am suggesting you redo the dance to suit my talent.
That might make it a rather short number, Miss Brock.
No regret that remark, Mr. Marsh. You may be the director of this show, but I'm driving the kiddie car.
So I want you all to go out and relax and forget about Pretty Lady until tomorrow. Then I want you to come back here and give the performance of your lives. Company dismissed. The tinsel and glitter of musical comedy. Just look at yourself. A speck of dust on this stage. Indistinguishable from the 40 other specks of dust that I put there.
I know that, Mr. Marsh. I'll put all those specks together. And you have something alive and beautiful that can reach out to 1,000 people you've never even seen before.
Broadway dreams, Sawyer. We've all had them.
Well, I need to hold on to mine, Mr. Marsh.
So did I. Sweet dreams, kid.
They are. I'm a speck of dust in your show.
Andy! Andy! Where the hell are you?
I'm right here, boss. Coming. I got all those notes packed up, all 7 pages.
I'm sitting and waiting. I've just decided to take some of my own advice and forget about everything until tomorrow. Now, Jones and Barry are throwing a party at the Regency. Come on, let's go dream a little.
Books!
Books! Oh, Thank you.
for tonight's performance of Pretty Lady. Ladies and gentlemen, your tickets will be refunded at the box office. Oh, house lights!
Thank you.
Riley. If there was someone in the company with that much talent, don't you think I would have noticed her?
Maybe not in this case.
We're wasting our time.
All you have to do is give her a chance. Is it anything better than closing the show?
Yeah. Who is she?
Peggy Sawyer.
That.
Yes, Peggy. She's got a voice that'll panic when she can dance rings around dry.
A raw beginner. This is her first job in the forest.
Now wait, boss. She's the best dancer in the line.
That's not carrying a show. Rock such an easy performer, she's fooled you. That sort of style takes years of experience to develop.
Unless this kid's got it naturally, which she just might have.
Do you realize how many pages she has to learn, not to mention the songs and routine?
She's young. Kids can do anything.
Speaking
of
the dancing, back
in
the show.
Julia, it's worth a try, isn't it?
All right,
send her. Wait a minute, there's another one hit. You just fired.
But it may not be too late to get her back. She's
paid
the
11th
and
an hour.
That gives you
20
minutes to get down
the road.
What do we do, boss?
Get her off that train. I want to start Aaron Leon ready to work at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Maybe those days here in Philadelphia.
My job. I fire her, it's up to me to get her back.
Who do you like, you know?
I said I'll go. Thank you, Eddie. You may have done me quite a favor.
Anytime, Marsh. Anytime.
We give you 15 minutes to pitch adventure, then we send in the big guns.
Listen to the love of Broadway.
Cyrus the Marshal is looking for my good luck scarf.
Lawyer, pretty lady opens on this stage in exactly 36 hours. Now, you have 25 pages, 6 songs, and 10 dance routines to learn by 8:30. You think you can do it. Do you think you can do it, Sawyer?
Yes, Mr. Marsh.
As we begin, Oscar, Mac, put out the piano. Andy!
Right here.
Come on, let's go, let's go.
All right.
All right, I want to start with the opening number, then work through all the songs and dances, then go back and do the scenes. There'll be a 5-minute break every hour for food or coffee, and a full 15 minutes every 4 hours for rest. And no one else on this stage until I call them.
Right, please.
Tomorrow night I'm either have a live leading lady or a dead chorus girl. All right, what are you waiting for? Let's go!
Well, I started out with the theater this afternoon. I wanted to tear your heart out. I wanted to hate you. I wanted to see you fail. You singing my songs, wearing my costume, playing my role. But sitting there in that theater and watching you rehearse, I found I couldn't hate you. Because you're good. Maybe better than I would have been. The public wants youth, freshness, beauty. And Peggy, that's what you've got. Only I'm getting something too. For 10 years, the theater has kept me away from the only thing I ever wanted. And it was a broken ankle that finally made me realize it. Pat Benny and I were married this morning.
Oh, Miss Brock.
Now I have one last wish for you, my dear. You get up there and be so swell, you'll make me hate you. Sawyer, I hope you won't mind this. It's the next to closing number. You've got to take it easy. Let the audience come to you. Would you let me show you what I mean?
Oh, we appreciate it very much.
Marsh with another one of his pep talks. Well, this is the last of them, Sawyer, and it comes straight from the heart. Our hopes, our futures, our lives are in your hands. Now make them shine tonight with your golden talent. This afternoon it was acting. This one I mean. You're going out there a youngster, but you've got to come back a star.
may meet those dancing feet.
On the avenue, I'm taking you to
every second street.
Thank you.
Now come on, we gotta go back to the party. We're ready.
Shut up, Sam. The party is rich. Am I really a star?
From now on and forever.
And can stars do anything they want?
Anything.
Then I want to go to the kids' party.
Thank you. You're changing your mind.
Of course, I'll be along. Wait for me at the station.
Okay, but just 1 minute. You know how impatient tenors are.
Thank you. Thank you.